Accessibility testing with DYNO Mapper. The first step of performing an accessibility test with DYNO Mapper is to create a project. Your project will designate a list of pages that you would like to run a test for or monitor for accessibility issues. Let's get started by creating a project. Click the New Project button and select your project creation method. You can test an entire website using the Create from URL or the Create from XML method. When creating from URL, you can utilize our crawler's features to define your list of pages. If you are unsure of what settings to use, just start by entering the URL and use our default settings. Click Show Advanced Options to see all of our Create from URL options. If you're trying to test a private website or application that requires a login, you'll need to use our website authentication. You can choose from our list of provided CMS systems. If your CMS does not appear on the list, you have the option to build a custom system login for your CMS or custom application. If you need help with the required settings, support is provided at any subscriber level. Just create a ticket and help is on its way. Two quick options to make note of are the only subdirectory and skip links options. If you only want to test a subdirectory of a site, click the Only Subdirectory button and add the directory with forward slashes included before and after the directory. You can also skip pages that match a URL structure using the Skip Links feature. Click the Skip Links and enter part of the URL. Select the matching type, then click Enter. If you'd like to learn more about each of our advanced settings, just click on the tooltip next to each option to learn more about what each option does. Creating a project from XML can be faster than crawling an entire website using the Create from URL. If you have a predefined list of pages in XML format, you can upload them using the URL or file to start your project. If you only have a few pages to test, you can use the Create from Scratch method to use our sitemap editor to define the pages to be included in your test. For an accessibility test, you only need to add a title or URL in the right side flyout. Make sure to enter the URL as it appears in browsers with the HTTP or HTTPS at the beginning of the URL. If you have several pages to test, click the plus or add item button to add additional pages. Don't forget to add each page title and URL, then click save. Repeat this step to add any additional pages that you need tested. After you've created a project using one of these three methods, you're ready to begin an accessibility test. Navigate to the accessibility page in the left side menu. Select a project you would like to perform a test on in the dropdown. Then click Run Test. It's recommended that you only test one standard at a time. This is especially important for accurate monitoring and reporting. You always have the option to duplicate your sitemap using the Create from Existing method if you need to monitor more than one standard in another project. After your test is finished, your results will be displayed in your accessibility test overview. An accessibility score is a project-wide average of each page tested. Your known, likely, and potential problems are displayed below your accessibility score, with the total number of broken guidelines listed below in each category from your most recent test. Each report is titled by the guideline test with a time and day stamp of when the test was performed. Use the schedule test to monitor your accessibility automatically. After your second test, you'll see the line graph that will track your progress. Click notifications to sign up and receive email alerts for each project test. Click View Report to see your page-by-page results. Use a guidelines group filter to show pages with a particular problem. Use the search bar to find pages that match a URL or page title. The search feature can be used to refine the list of pages displayed based on a common part of a set of URLs. Click Export to generate a project-wide report. You can select from the CSV or PDF option. Our PDF option includes your accessibility score, a guideline summary, and an impact summary that details the number of problems, the number of pages the problem is present on, and the percentage of pages with that issue. To view a page's detail, click Review. Your individual page accessibility score can be viewed here. You can navigate through a page's known, likely, and potential problems by clicking the tabs. We show the guideline category, criteria number, line where the error can be found, and code samples that can be helpful in identifying the problems in your code. After you have fixed accessibility problems in your live environment, you can either run your test again or go to the Accessibility Test Overview page and retest the individual page by clicking Refresh. There are many situations where you'll want to manually archive problems. This is especially critical when testing a standard like WCAG 2.1, where most of the new criteria requires manual testing. You have several options to manually remove a problem from an accessibility test. On the right side of the accessibility test review, you will see a dropdown for archive issues. In the dropdown menu, use the archive problem when you need to archive a problem or set of problems only once. Select the problem or problems in the left side and select Archive Problem from the Archive Issues dropdown. Use the Always Archive Problem on this page to prevent the same problems from showing up in any future test of a specific page. Use the Always Archive Problem in all pages to prevent the same problems from showing up in any future test of all pages within a project. Using this option is a huge time saver during remediation. You can manually remove problems and clear out any false positives that you have identified. Any criteria that requires manual testing will be flagged with the message "Manual Testing Required." If you check and believe your project has passed a particular criteria, use the Archive Issues dropdown to remove that problem from the report. You'll have a copy of all archived issues in the Archive tab. If you archive a problem in error, just go back to the Archive tab, select the item or items, and select Add to Problems from the Archive Issues dropdown. You'll need to refresh your browser to see any changes to a report after manual archiving. You can visualize errors by clicking the Visualize link. This will open up your URL within our DYNO Analytics Live Browser tool. With our Live Browser tool, you can select different standards and also review accessibility problems visually. If you click on each icon of the Live Report, a pop-up will launch with the problem details. If you'd like to delete one or more reports, click the Delete button located next to each report that you would like to delete. Please note that deleting a sitemap project will automatically delete all corresponding accessibility reports permanently from our system.